friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. It's Sasha. I'm briefly just cleaning my workspace because I just did a get ready with me video, and as I was doing that video, guess what dropped? Well, guess what I found out that dropped, because it didn't drop just now. Our boy from GOT7, YUGYEOM, has a new company, and with his new company, it's AOMG official, and I'm officially subscribing to them. With his new company, they put out a franchise dance visual, Travis Scott featuring Young Thug and MIA. I typically enjoy, I use that loosely, I don't always love, but I can handle Travis Scott a little bit more than some of the other artists that are out there today. But listen, I've tried to pick a bias for GOT7, and YUGYEOM has made that list more than once. It like alters depending on the day, but he's really up there for me. I think it is the dancing and his personality. Anyway, none of that matters. I'm just so excited to watch this and see what it is. I'm going to just watch it once, and then I'm going to watch it again and take notes so we can try and talk about the dancing. I haven't seen this yet at all. There are already so many reactions out about this. I will probably never be a person who has their reaction out the same day. I don't live that life. But maybe like a few days later, we'll see. Okay, how's my volume? Bring it up a little bit. All right, here we go. My God. I went on the stand, told the judge, pass my cup. Hey, ran up 20 million, told the devil, keep the look, keep the hope, keep the smoke. They talk to me nicely. Keep her on the chain, that ain't like Scots with no strings, you can't die with the home. I'm higher than the come on. Nice. Come on. My box is a chest, not my Nikes. Let's go. Yeah, you know that. And when they free us, I'm gonna be a film. A Kodak. Shoot me born right above the rim. Like Polak. I've been ripping and running. I slipping on sliding athletic tendencies. I've been upset, shoving and whipping into the base rock. I provide the remedy. When they open gates up at Utopia, it's like Zootopia. You see the crosses over you. You know it's us. FOAM, I'm phony up. Not for no shoulder up. Them jack boys up and clean us up. The way this they is sick. Yeah, in my white tee. Yeah, call up hype. Williams for the hype, please. Yeah, they gon' wipe. Go off, King. Go off. Yeah, my box is a checks, not my. Checks, not my. I be where the fuck the light be. Okay. Bangers in the system, it's the bangers in the system, it's ancient anarchy. Bangers in the system, it's that bangers in the system.
to miss that.
Dang. Dang.
And my A's.
I love the concept of being introduced to the world by your new company because they are so effing proud to have you. Like, gosh, that's just big props to AOMG. I don't know if they do this for every artist they get. I would hope that they do, for continuity's sake and not to play favorites. Well, it's hard because maybe not every person they sign is an established artist yet, but if they're signing them, they hopefully see enough potential in them that they would treat them in a similar way they would treat an established artist. I don't know. I don't know much about agencies or that relationship. That was never part of the sphere I was in. When I was a dancer, I was just at studios or at schools. That, like, I'm very small town dancer vibe. I'm not professional in any capacity. But it is just so cool to me that they made this video literally to show the world their new artist that they just signed. That's so dope. That's so cool. He's killing it. He's absolutely killing it. This reminds me of Hit the Stage, but like, I don't know, not even 2.0, just like all grown up. Like a bigger, better version of Hit the Stage. And it, yeah, I think, gosh, I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna watch it again. I'm gonna take notes. I might fast forward through this part or cut it out and just go to the notes at the end. I'll see what happens after filming and editing, but I'm gonna watch it again. Okay, so here are some of my notes. My first one is a question. I know at the end they list the dancers as they're doing their freestyle, but are those dancers all signed under the same management company or agency? I don't know. I hope so, because that would be dope. It's like all of them dancing with their new co-worker, essentially. I don't know. Not that they're all going to do projects together every time, but it would be cool. It would just be cool. There's something about YUGYEOM when he dances that I don't see it with many other idols, and it's because I guess in my mind YUGYEOM is so much more, I don't want to put it a certain way and make certain people upset by what I say, so please know I'm trying my best to word this in the best way possible. But I see YUGYEOM more as a dancer than I do an idol. I hope that makes sense. I'm not trying to take anything away from him. He has a great voice. He has great presence in the music videos. Like, he's definitely an asset to GOT7 in more ways than just his dancing. But what I'm going to say next relates to the fact that I see him mostly as a dancer and not as an idol. Here's why. Watch him and then watch the dancers around him in this video specifically. He very much keeps his chest, like, not puffed out in an extreme way, but he keeps his chest up so straight and his torso just so straight for most of this dance that it creates like a cocky confidence that isn't cocky because it just is him. And he's just so sure of himself, as he should be, because look at him. That's not to say that he doesn't dance with his torso when he needs to. He does break and move his torso, but for a lot of the movements, he's just like chest up, moving his legs, moving his head and arms. But if you watch, he's just so postured. And I don't see that a lot with idols. You do see it more with dancers. I really liked his facials when he was smiling, when he's giving us like a face, just the emotion. I loved that the dancers were playing with each other throughout this, high-fiving each other, looking at each other, grooving off of each other. And that's before we get to the freestyle part, which was sick. So, like, great job. This whole video really just feels like dance appreciation. Like, obviously, it's YUGYEOM appreciation because that's why the video was made. But I say overall dance appreciation because we do get a freestyle at the end with every single performer, unless I miscounted. I think every single person who was in the formations of the main choreography got their own freestyle moment at the end of the video. That doesn't typically happen. I'm thinking back to another K-pop idol who had a freestyle moment in the end of their video, and that's J-Hope with Chicken Noodle Soup with Becky G. And they had freestyle at the end of their video, but they had like hundreds of extras. So they obviously couldn't have each individual dancer highlighted at the end. But here, when you have a smaller group, it shows a different level of respect to the art and to the individual to allow all of them to have their own moment in a video that is highlighting your new artist. That to me makes me feel so comfortable that this is the group that he chose to be with, because I can see how much they respect each person. Right? Do you see that? Do you see that? Is it just me? It can't be just me. I did also like in the choreography how through most of it, he would be still and just like standing there while the dancers would do something, and then he would jump in, and then it reversed at the very end where the dancers stood still when we were above and it was just him doing his feet like that. And I was like, oh, we switched it. Okay, nice. It was entertaining to watch. And back to sort of the facials, the thing I always look for to see if a person is actually really having fun with what they're doing, and there's a difference between is a person having fun and dancing, or is this a competition and they can't be having fun right now? Does that make sense? Like, obviously you hope when you're competing you are enjoying yourself, but if you're doing a contemporary or a ballet, you can't just like let loose. But this is obviously completely different, so this applies here. But there's a part in the dance where he just lets his head go, and that's my key to be like, oh man, he's feeling it, he's loving this, he's having such a good time. If this is what we see from him and this group for the very first time, I'm very excited for what's gonna come next. I'm wondering if he's gonna continue down this like strictly hip-hop road. I'm pretty sure that's what this group is more known for, so that wouldn't be surprising, but it is quite a deviation from GOT7. So I'm very interested to see what he puts out in the future, excited for him and for all of his fans, excited to see GOT7 back together one day, excited for Mark and his live streams being home. I'm so happy for all of them, honestly, and yeah. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time. Bye.